Also lined up for elections on the same Sunday is Ivory Coast. The election there is not considered a tight contest, but the incumbent president, Alassane Ouattara, is not taking chances. Section of the opposition, however, won the vote postponed to allow for what they call national reconciliation.
Across Ivory Coast, the mood is clear. The West African nation is on election footing, with President Alassane Draman Ouattara, or ADO as he's popularly known, tipped to win another term in office. But at this neighborhood in Abidjan, this group is here to tell a different story. These are members of the Pan-African Congress for Justice and Equality Party, one of the parties supporting former President Laurent Gbagbo, who is currently facing crimes against humanity charges at the International Criminal Court. They claim the country is too divided to go for an election, and they want a national conversation before the polls can take place.
The opposition is calling for a dialogue. Can we not speak with the opposition before the elections? It's always doable.
Ivory Coast is only just recovering from a crippling civil war that split the country right down the middle for nearly a decade. The general election of 2010 was won by Ouattara, but Gbagbo refused to concede defeat, setting off clashes that left some 3,000 people dead.
In 2010,
there was a huge crisis, so we need to reconcile before heading to elections. If we don't reconcile, how can there be elections?
Gbagbo supporters have alleged that the outcome of the election is a foregone conclusion, charging that the country's election commission has tilted the field in favor of the incumbent president.
We knew Pugon, so here many are saying that the elections have been decided in advance and there is no point in coming to vote.
Ouattara, a former governor of the Central Bank of West African States and a deputy head of the International Monetary Fund, is credited with turning around the country's economy following the civil war. His closest challenger is a former Prime Minister Pascal Affi N'Guessa of the Ivorian Popular Front. But Ouattara's supporters say Sunday's vote will be a walkover. The economy has boomed in recent years and Ivory Coast is now the world's biggest exporter of cocoa, producing around 40% of the planet's beans used to manufacture chocolate. But this year, it has also overtaken India as the leading exporter of cashew nuts. Jogeo, KTN News.